When Americans any place in our great country are suffering, we have to act. We should act. That's one of the Senate's responsibilities. Imagine everyone here if you had to worry every day about your children and the water they can bathe in, drink, brush their teeth. Well, the people of Flint, Michigan worry about that every day. All they have is bottled water. And they're suffering through this. It's no fault of their own. It's a man-made disaster. All Americans deserve clean, safe drinking water. Not just some of us, everybody. They deserve more than hollow talking points. No matter how many times they're repeated, they deserve real action. Senator Stabenow and Peters continue to work toward a bipartisan deal. There's one there. We just need the Republicans to agree. We need to work on this. The people in Flint, Michigan are desperate. 9,000 children under age 6 have been poisoned with lead. It's also important to act very aggressively on the Zika virus. I'm very encouraged by the aggressive action taken by the President and his announcement about why we need to do something now, not some other time, but now. We need to get ahead of the curve here. Later today, Ranking Members Murray, Nelson, Cantwell, Cardin will join Republicans at a briefing with Secretary Burwell on the Zika virus. I hope that following the briefing, we'll be able to act responsibly to deliver important funding to combat Zika. There's no reason for us to be, this should not be a political issue. We can act together to fund these important priorities for the American people and actually for the world. This is an important message that we're sending to the rest of the world. Senator Durbin?
In New Hampshire, the Republican presidential candidates are debating who's in favor of the most extreme form of waterboarding. I'm not making this up. Here in Washington, we are debating how to deal with water quality, where literally thousands of children have been poisoned in Flint, Michigan. What a contrast in the priorities of two political parties. We believe that there are appropriate and important roles for government when it comes to making sure that the water our kids drink is safe. The government has to step in to an important regulatory role. When it comes to making sure that we are doing everything in our power to protect our people against the Zika virus, the government has to step in and do this. When it comes to the safety of tank cars going through our communities filled with flammable liquids, it's up to the government to regulate it. So when you hear the Republicans groaning and moaning about too much regulation, ask them about whether there was too much regulation in Flint, Michigan, whether there's too much regulation protecting us against the Zika virus, or too much regulation making sure the railroads are acting safely and responsibly. The right balance is what we seek. The extreme that we hear on the other side is not responsive to the real challenges of American families.
Schumer?
Well, our friends on the other side of the aisle have talked a big game about some of the crises we face, but so far, they have yet to walk the walk. The people of Flint can't drink endless Republican speeches about solving the lead crisis. They need new pipes to pump clean water and help deal with the health care needs that will last for decades. All the lip service in the world isn't going to protect Americans from the Zika virus, which was just found today in Indiana and Ohio. Senator McConnell called for a meeting. The President's put forward a billion-dollar program, well thought out. We urge our Republican colleagues to not just talk or call meetings, to act, to support this legislation. Democrats have real plans to address these issues. It's time for Republicans to stop sitting on their hands and do something about these problems. Senate Democrats sent a letter to the White House to come up with a strong strategy to stop Zika in its tracks, and now it's up to us to fund the emergency supplemental the President had asked for. If anything qualifies as an emergency that deserves all hands on deck, it's the spread of viruses like Zika. This can't be a time for partisan politics to get in the way of solutions the American people deserve. It's time for action, and we're in a new era. Safety and security are paramount to the American people. This idea of simply cutting back, doing nothing, giving speeches, blaming and tying the hands of those who can do something about it in the federal government is important. The private sector isn't going to stop the Zika virus. The private sector isn't going to get the lead out of the water or the pipes in Flint. The private sector isn't going to be able to protect us if from ISIS. We need all hands on deck, and we're calling on our Republican colleagues, no more speeches, no more authorizations and talk and then cut the appropriations. It is time to act for the safety and security of the American people.
Senator Murray.
Well, right now, the people across the country are getting a good hard look at Republican values and priorities. Their party leaders are making them pretty clear. Senator Cruz, who is the architect of the government shutdown and leader of the fight to defund Planned Parenthood, is laying out his plans now to attack workers and turn back the progress that we've made. Donald Trump, leading in the polls in the primary, is talking about new ways to divide our country. And Senator Rubio seems to be under a lot of pressure, but at least now he's being consistent. So while Republican leaders are showing middle-class families exactly what they would do if they had control of all of government, Democrats are making it clear here in the Senate, we want to keep working on the issues that our families care about. That's why we are calling on Republicans to work with us to address the shameful issue of poisoned water in Flint and communities across our country. We are pushing Republicans to put politics aside and work with us and the President to make sure the federal government does have the resources it needs to tackle the Zika outbreak and protect women and families. And we will be making the case every single day for Republicans to join us at the table, work on policies that actually help our workers and grow the economy from the middle out. Things like making college more affordable, reducing the crushing student debt problem in this country, raising the minimum wage, so much more. So we are ready to keep working, and we call on Senate Republicans to please ignore the party leaders out there today and work with us to get things done for the American people.
Any questions? Yes. No, I didn't make one 8 years ago. I won't make one now. I have a number of goals. One is to make sure the process is as fair as possible. And number two, register as many Democrats as possible. We registered 8 years ago tens of thousands of Democrats, new Democrats. And for my getting involved at this stage, it would cut down the number of people who would register.
Yeah. There's some discussion over in the House among Republicans about wanting to walk away from the $30 billion in additional spending that was part of the 2 year budget deal. Do you have any reaction to that, or how do you think that would impact discussions on this side?
Well, that's an issue that the Speaker is going to have to deal with. We have the laws in effect now. I support what we did last year, and we're going to do everything that we can to maintain that. It's extremely important to the American people that we have a strong, vibrant military, but it's also important we have a strong, vibrant middle class, and that's what we did last December.
Leader, in your home state, recently the Sanders campaign had taken some tactics about its staffers posing as members of the Culinary Union. Now they've apologized for them. Are you concerned about those tactics being going on in your home state?
I think that the campaign between in Nevada, between Hillary and Bernie, is everyone's trying to be as fair as possible.
Leary, what's your reaction to Republicans who are attempting to or say they want to raise defense spending through OCO or other means?
Well, I already said that I think that they must be living in a time warp. We've already been through that. I don't think they want to close government again. The law's in effect, and we're going to stick with what we did last December. Yes.
Senator Inhofe said that that President Obama has proposed a net cut in clean water funding in his budget. He says he gives to one fund but takes away even more in another. I just wonder if you think President Obama did enough in his budget to.
Well, for the first time in the history of the country, the Republicans are not holding a hearing on a presidential budget. If they have problems with that budget, hold a hearing on it. We'll talk about it. But for them to be doing some guerrilla warfare in this massive document that we've just been given without even having the audacity, without even having the courtesy to do a hearing on the bill is something that I can't understand. It's never been done before, but this Republican caucus has a lot of things they've never done before in this country, and they're doing it. Thanks, everybody.